Well, I suppose first of all, let me say that, that we're predominantly inshore fishermen, so the common fisheries policy doesn't directly impact on us, but indirectly, I suppose, career-wise and everything, when we started out 20 years ago, if the common fisheries policy wasn't so restrictive against Irish fishing, we might have entertained a career at sea on Irish boats, but that's not possible now because the fleet has diminished nearly to nothing.
Well, we need control over it, but we need to change the CFP as well, like, because even if we got control in the morning and you stay with the same CFP, the way that's set up, like, the big countries are taking all they want and we're left with nothing. I mean, we have, in the total percentage, we have a fish we can catch in our own waters anyway to like 15% or something. And that's a ridiculous amount of fish for outside our own door, like.
The big mistake in the past is that there was no value given to the potential that lay off the Irish coast at that point in time. There's a realisation now that there is huge value there if it was exploited for the benefit of the common good of the people of the island. And if you look at the amount of various statistics and surveys that have been done, estimated maybe over 200 billion of Irish fish has been taken out of Irish waters by foreign vessels since 1972.
Now, unfortunately, when they were sharing it out, the Irish fleet was very underdeveloped. Now, since then, we've developed a good bit, but we're restricted with quotas, and there's also a ceiling on our capacity. They call it tonnage. But so we can't increase our fishery, even if we tried under the present rules.
Right. With the quota now, you have to... you're told like what you can catch, say 2 ton of monk per month or something. And once you go over that, then you have to dump any other monk you catch, like. So you're dumping perfectly good fish for no good reason, while there are other boats from other countries fishing around you. And because they have a larger quota, they can catch what you have to leave after, like. So there's no conservation at all. Fish is either being caught by another country or it's being dumped back dead in the sea.
Now there's a pollution issue there as well as a cost issue, so it seems ridiculous that this dumping at sea seems a ridiculous restriction on quarters. It seems a silly way to have compliance for quarters.
The whole conservation issue is something that I think every fisherman wants to be part of, because you're talking about their future, irrespective of where they come from within the European Union or in the world. Because if we fish something out and exploit it and rape it, there is nothing there for the future. So I believe fishermen and women certainly want to be part of that. The situation has been, a lot of the scientific analysis has been done without any input from the stakeholders, from the fishing sector themselves. And many people involved in the fishing sector would believe that it is very inaccurate.
I don't think they're reasonable because they're taking the scientists' view only, and it's the guys on the ground, the fellas out in the boat, the fishermen, the skippers, they're the ones that they should also take note of their assessment of stock.
Yeah, in the case of bass now, say Irish boats can't catch them at all. We have no commercial fishing for bass, like, it was closed, I suppose 20 years ago bass fishing was closed in the name of conservation. But as far as I know, no check has been done since to see how the conservation has worked. And the French can come in within 6 miles of our coast and catch all the bass they like. They can come into an Irish port then and land it and sell it to us, which makes a mockery of it altogether.
Compliance is always an issue, and enforcement is always an issue. Now, there's no... it's true to say that wherever you have a rule, enforcement is not the issue at all. It's the way they enforce it. And now, as I said about the dumping at sea, if they had maybe a fine for over quota or a cost, so that they could keep the excess fish and pay something towards it, it may be more reasonable way. Again, I'm not the person that would decide that, but it seems to me that there's a lack of common sense in the whole issue of quotas.
definitely paid for all our benefits that we've got from Europe, you know, that all these road improvements where you said that this structure was supported by the EU. We've paid, it may have been supported, but we paid for it in fish. Like if they calculated the value of the fish that's going out the road every day to pay for, you know, into Europe that's been caught by European boats, that's certainly paid. We've the books balanced with Europe. Like we don't do the, we certainly don't do them nothing for the road improvements anyway.
We gave more in our fisheries away than we ever got back in structural funds. So they need to take fishing seriously in this country and have good representation.
Essentially, the first thing to do is have an all-party approach in the interest of Irish fishing fleet and the fishing industry in general. And that means that those of us of all political persuasion coming together in an agreed position to put the maximum pressure on the EU Commissioner and obviously the EU Commissioner in general. And also to try and build alliances with other like-minded countries who are within the European framework, who are obviously feel aggrieved as we certainly do.